குட் டே பீப்புள், திஸ் இஸ் ஹீரா தீபிகா இன் பொன்னியின் செல்வன். திஸ் இஸ் எபிசோட் நம்பர் 11. வென் வந்தியத்தேவன் ஆஸ்க் நம்பி அபவுட் த சக்சஷன் டு த த்ரோன், ஹி ரிப்ளைட் தட் தி அஸ்ட்ராலஜர் ஆஃப் குடந்தை மைட் பி ஏபிள் டு ப்ரெடிக்ட் அபவுட் த சக்சஷன். அண்ட் ஸோ ஆ ஹீரோ வந்தியத்தேவன் லேண்டட் இன் குடந்தை அஸ்ட்ராலஜர்ஸ் ஹவுஸ். The astrologer led Vandiyadevan into the house after the prince's chariot had disappeared from view. Once both of them were seated, the astrologer asked for Vandiyadevan's details.
Thambi, who are you? From where have you come?
You're such a famous astrologer. Can you not find from your astrology about who I am and why I came here?
Oh, is that so? I can find out,
said the astrologer. Vandiyadevan then asked, Sir, those two who came here before me, who are they? Vandiyadevan tried to get to know the prince's identities from the astrologer, but the astrologer did not reveal anything about it. The astrologer said,
Thambi, listen to this. Several people will come and go from an astrologer's house. One should not talk about one visitor to another. I will not tell you anything about the person who left just now. Neither will I disclose a single word about you to any person who may come later and ask about you.
Ah, everything that Alvarkadiyan Nambi said about you seems to be true.
Alvarkadiyan? Who is he?
What? Don't you know him? He talked as if he knew you very well. Have you never heard of Alvarkadiyan Nambi?
Perhaps I might know the man, but I don't remember his name. Describe him a little. Let me see.
He is short and squat. He wears his hair in a top knot on his forehead. Vandiyadevan described Alvarkadiyan's identity.
Thambi, from what you say, I think you are talking about Tirumalai.
Oh, that Vaishnava has different name in different towns. Does he also disguise himself as a different person as per the situation?
Oh yes, he will put on acts appropriate for the occasion and time. About 7/8 of what he says will be full of imagination, and the rest may be gospel truth.
So you say that he is a very wicked fellow.
One cannot say that, Thambi. He is good to the good, bad to the wicked.
Can you predict something for me by your astrology? Foretell something for me. It's already getting late and I have to go in a hurry.
Where do you have to go in such a hurry, my son?
Can you not reveal that also from your astrology? Where should I go? Where should I not go? If I do go, will my endeavor be successful? I came to ask you all these things.
I need some basis to foretell or predict by my astrology. I need a horoscope to study. If there's no horoscope, I must at least know the day and star under which you are born. If you do not know even that, I need a name and address.
My name is Vallavarayan.
Aha. Of the Vana clan?
Yes, I am that very same Vandiyadevan Vallavarayan.
Oh, wow, Thambi, why did you not say this before? I think I even have your horoscope with me. If I search for it, I can find it.
How is that, sir?
What other occupation do astrologers like me have? We collect all the horoscopes of men and women born in noble families.
I am not from such famous noble family.
How can you say that? Do you not know of the fame and prestige of your clan? How many poets have sung the praises of the Vana clan in so many poems? Perhaps you have not heard the poems.
Saying so, the astrologer sung one of the poems.
The poem
is pleasing to the ear, sir, but my current situation is in no way related to the poem. We've lost everything now, said Vandiyadevan.
Today your situation may be like that. How do we know what can happen tomorrow?
Mr. Astrologer, what do the planets and stars foretell about me?
They foretell that you will grow day by day. If you ask me about something in particular, I can also be specific.
Tell me about the business on which I am going to Thanjavur. Will it succeed?
If you are going to Thanjavur on your own behalf, the endeavor will succeed. If you are going on someone else's behalf, I have to see that person's horoscope before I answer.
Vandiyadevan shook his head in astonishment. Sir, I have never encountered such a clever fellow like you. Okay, let me ask what I want clearly. I wish to meet the emperor in Thanjavur. Is that possible?
There are two more astrologers greater than me in Thanjavur. You have to ask them.
Who are they, sir?
One is the elder Paruvetaraya and the other is his brother, the younger Paruvetaraya.
It is said that the health of emperor is in a bad state. Is that true?
People will say all sorts of things, Sambi. Why not? Don't believe all that they say. Neither should you repeat such things.
Can you tell me who has the right to succeed to the Chola throne if something happens to the emperor?
That throne is not for you nor for me. Why should we then bother about it?
From that fate we are saved, said Vandiyadevan. Sir, at present, the prince who is in Kanchi, the crown prince Aditya Karikalar.
Yes, he is there. And you've come on his behalf, haven't you?
Aha, you found out that in the end. No harm then, but what about his fortune?
I don't have his horoscope in my hands right now, Tambi. I have to study on that.
What about the fortunes of Prince Madhurandhakar?
This is a peculiar fortune, similar to that of women folk. His fortunes are always subject to the power of others.
Even now, people say that the Chola Empire is under women's rule. They say that it is worse than the rule of Queen Ali.
Tambi, where do they say such things?
To the north of Kolledum.
Maybe they are talking about the power of the younger queen of Paruvetaraya.
But I heard it differently.
What did you hear?
They say that the beloved daughter of emperor, the younger Prati Kundavai, is the one ruling like that. The astrologer peered into Vandiyadevan's face carefully. He tried to read the face to find out if he was saying these words after recognizing Kundavai, who had left his house a little earlier. There was no sign to support the doubt.
Totally wrong, Tambi. Emperor Sundara Chola is in Thanjavur. Kundavai Prati lives in Palayarai. Moreover
what? Why did you stop?
During the daytime, one must look in all four directions before speaking. At night time, not even that. But there is nothing wrong in telling you, I think. What power or influence does the emperor have these days? All the authority is held by the Paruvetarayas.
After saying this, the astrologer examined Vandiyadevan's face once again. Sir, I am not a spy of the Paruvetarayas. You do not have to suspect me of that. A little while ago, you spoke about the impermanence of kingdoms and royal dynasties. You gave me the example of my own Varnar clan. Please tell me the truth. How is the future of the Chola dynasty?
I can tell truthfully without any uncertainty. Towards the end of the spring, the river Kaveri and its tributaries will be filled with new floods. The people living on the river banks know that very well, that it is a flood that will rise day by day. Till the beginning of the summer months, the flood will keep rising. By the autumn months, the waters begin to recede. The people living along the bank realize it to be a ebbing flood. The Chola Empire is now like the fresh flood of springtime that grows day by day. For several more hundreds of years, it will grow and spread. The Chola Empire is now a waxing moon. The day of the full moon is far away. Therefore, the Chola power will expand more and more.
After speaking all this time, you've said one thing explicitly. Thank you. If possible, just tell me one more thing. I have a great desire to go on a ship and travel to distant lands.
That wish will definitely be fulfilled. You have the fortune of the wheel. You will be traveling constantly as if you have wheels on your feet. You will go by walk, ride upon horses, go on elephants, and you will also travel aboard ships. You have the fortune to go on a sea voyage very soon.
Sir, about the commander of the southern armies, Arulmozhivarmar, who is now conducting a campaign in Lanka. What do the planets and stars say about him?
Thambi, those travelling by ship use an instrument made of the magnetic stone to find their directions. Lighthouses also help these sailors. But do you know what aids the ship in the midst of the open seas? What is the constant friend of the sailors? It is the pole star seen in the low northern skies. The other stars and planets all keep moving from their positions. Even the group of the seven spheres travels in a circle, but the pole star is never shaken from its fixed position. The younger son of the emperor, Arulmozhivarmar, is like that pole star. He has the firmness of mind unshaken by anything. In addition to the virtues of the selflessness and morality, he possesses the goodness of bravery. He excels in worldly knowledge as much as in the learning. He has a charming face like that of a young baby, which calms the pains of those who gaze upon it. He is the darling son of the angel of good luck. Just as sailors take direction from the pole star, it will be very useful if youth like you who embark on the adventure of life take the direction from Arulmozhivarmar.
Dear me, what is all that you are describing about Prince Arulmozhivarmar? It appears to be like a poem written on a lover by his partner.
Maybe if you ask any fellow of the Chola country on the banks of the river Pony, they'll say the same.
Thank you, Mr. Astrologer. If the need arises, I shall follow your advice.
Because I saw that your lucky planets are also on the rise. And so I said this, said the astrologer.
I shall take leave of you, sir, now, along with my heartfelt thanks offered gladly. Please accept this small tribute of gold offered to you. Saying this, Vandiyadevan placed 5 gold coins in the palms of the astrologer.
The benevolence of the Vanar clan has not died even now,
said the astrologer as he took the coins from Vandiyadevan. In those days, those who wished to reach Tanjavur from Kudandai travelled along the banks of the rivers Arisilaru or Kaveri and reached the town of Thiruvayaru. From there, they would turn south to go towards Tanjavur. Convenient ferries or forts to cross the rivers Kudamuruti, Vettaru, Vennaru and Vadavaru were available only along that road. Vandiyadevan, who started from Kudandai, first went towards the banks of Arisilaru. Vandiyadevan rode onwards with thoughts occupying his mind. The lush green sceneries of the Chola kingdom present along the way dragged him off and on from his dreamy world to the reality. Finally, he reached the banks of the Arisilaru. After going a few yards, he heard the sound of women laughing and the jingles of their bracelets. The women were completely hidden by the thick groves of trees growing on the bank. He peered into the trees, trying to locate the women who made the noise. Suddenly, he could hear the fear-filled screams.
"Oh dear! I help! It's a crocodile!"
said the voices of several women. He whipped his horse in the direction of the shouts. Their faces were filled with fright. But to his surprise, two of them seemed to be the very same women he had seen in the astrologer's house. Vandiyadevan recognized all this within a fraction of a second. That was not all. A horrible crocodile, opening its jaws wide, could be seen at the foot of a thick tree trunk, blending with the roots, half in the water and half on the bank. He had recently seen one such fearful crocodile in the floods of the Kollidam River. He had heard how dangerous the beast was. Therefore, when he saw the reptile, his heart skipped a beat and his whole body froze with agitation for a minute. The crocodile was very near the girls who had been laughing merrily a few moments earlier. It was opening its horrible jaws wide and appeared monstrous. The crocodile had to only move just one step closer. One of the girls would be gone. She could not escape because of the thick tree behind her. However confused his heart and mind was, there was nothing wrong with his courage. He did not even think beyond a second about what he should do. He took a very careful aim and swiftly threw the spear in his hand. The spear pierced the crocodile's back, entered deep into its hide and stood upright. Our hero immediately jumped off his horse and drawing his sword, he rushed towards the reptile to finish it off in one stroke. He heard the girls laughing once again like before. The sound was repulsive to Vandiyadevan's ears. Why do these foolish women laugh like this at such a dangerous situation? Let's catch up on those details in the next episode. Please do subscribe to my channel and enable the bell notifications icon to continue listening to this wonderful epic novel. Thank you.